Hello everyone, I welcome you to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of PHP, that is PHP version 8.3.0 on the Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily create a simple Hello World PHP program and how to run that on our console. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues in middle, please put a comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. And also, if you like this video, please give it a like, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel. That will really help me to make more such videos. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install PHP, first you need to go to your favorite browser, and in the address bar you need to just simply search with PHP download and hit enter. This will show you this www.php.net as our first search result. So here you can clearly see we have a download, you know, link. So just simply click on this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of PHP. So this link I'm going to put right in our description. So here you can see we have so many options. So for Windows, you need to click on this Windows download link and it's going to redirect to this page. So here if you see, we have non-thread safe and thread safe. So from here I'm going to download the thread safe one. So click on this zip link, and it's going to start downloading our PHP. Alright, I have already downloaded it, so I'll simply minimize it. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can clearly see that we have the latest version of PHP version 8.3.0 is already been downloaded over here. So you need to just simply right click on it and you need to click on extract all, and it just you need to click on extract, and it's going to extract it right in our location. And here you can see that it is rightly extracted over here. So let's go our directory back. So within our software folder, we had the zip file, and here is our extracted folder. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to right click on this folder, and I'm going to click on show more options, and I want to rename this. I'll keep it simple, just PHP 8.3.0, right? So, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to just simply right click on it and click on cut. And I'm going to paste this in our C drive. So you can right click and paste. Right. So here you can see that if you go inside, we have our PHP 8.3 folder. We have all files and folders over here. All right. So now that you have rightly pasted in our C drive, this PHP 8.3.0, all you need to do is click on this address bar, then right click and copy the path. And now you need to click on the search icon and just simply type over here environ. It will show you this edit the system environment variables. Open that. And now you need to click on this environment variables, and it will open environment variables window. Here you need to click on path and you need to click on edit. So once you click on edit, it will open the edit environment variable. Click on new. Then again right click and paste the path over here. So that C:\php-8.3.0 folder is what we are going to paste it over here. Click on OK. Again click on OK. And again click on OK. So after you've done with that, you know that your PHP is rightly installed. So now how you'll verify whether PHP is rightly installed? So for that, you need to go to search again and just simply type over here cmd. And if you open the command prompt, here, if you just simply type php space dash dash version and simply hit enter, you can see the latest version of PHP version 8.3.0 is rightly installed over here. So that's why you are getting this prompt. If you see some different message like PHP is not recognized, alright, so that sort of message means your PHP is not installed properly. So now that you know that your PHP is rightly installed, it's time to create a simple Hello World program in PHP. So for that, I'm going to create a new folder over here, and I'm going to name this folder as PHP. And I'll just simply go inside this folder. I'll create a new text document. So I'm going to give that document name as Hello, and I'm going to change this TXT with PHP. Hit enter. If you want to change this file, click on yes. So here you can see that it has become hello.php. So if you don't see this extension .txt or .php, all that basically you need to do is you need to click on view, and you need to click on show, and you need to enable this file name extension. Alright, so once when your file name extension is enabled, you'll be able to see this .php or .txt extension. Now I need to open this file in Notepad. I'll open this in Notepad and here I'll write code. So angular bracket PHP. And I'll end the bracket, and here I'm just simply going to echo hello world. That's all. Hello world. I'll go to file and I'll save this file. And now I'll go back to my folder. I'll just simply type over here cmd. So it will open our command prompt right at this location. If you see right at this location, our command prompt is lightly open. Now all you need to do is you need to just simply type php, then your file name, which is hello.php. hello.php. So first you need to use that php command and then your file name. Hit enter and there you go. You can see the output hello world is rightly shown over here. All right. So in this way, you can easily install latest version of PHP, that is PHP version 8.3.0 on your Windows operating system. And after that, I have also shown you how you can easily create a simple hello world program on PHP and how to run that on our console. All right. So the next thing that I am going to recommend you is to install XAMPP. So for that, again, I have made a little video. As you know that PHP is a server-side language, so you need some sort of server locally hosted so that you can run any sort of PHP project. So for that, you need some server. XAMPP will provide you that. All right. So in that video, I have detailed showed you how you can easily create, you know, any sort of PHP project and work on server-side programming language so that, you know, you can build up your career in web development. All right. So I'll be recommending you to watch that video as well. So that's basically all about this video. Please do like, share and subscribe. That will really help me to make more such videos. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all. And you can see that our XAMPP control panel is rightly opened over here. So you can see it has some module like Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury and Tomcat. So from here I'm going to, you know, start Apache. So I'll click on the start button and same I'm going to do for MySQL. All right. So as soon as you do that, you can see that all these Apache and MySQL